WP40 6-inch sheet membrane must be applied to all plywood seams for reinforcement. WP40 may also be installed behind or on top of the flashing as a backup waterproofing measure. WP40 should not be exposed to the sun for more than 7 days. The WP40 36-inch sheet membrane can be installed to the entire deck when maximum protection is required. WP43 sheet membrane primer should be applied by brush or roller, leaving no puddles. Prime only as much as surface can be covered with the WP40 sheet membrane in 4 hours. Do not cover wet primer. Allow primer to become tacky, then apply the WP40 sheet membrane within 24 hours. Primed areas not covered within 8 hours must be reprimed. Roll out the sheet membrane with the white side up. Measure individual lengths and overlap the sheet membrane a minimum of 2 inches. Remove the remaining film and adhere to the deck. Pull the material tight from each end and remove the 2.5-inch strip of overlap release film and adhere to the deck. Westcoat requires a minimum of 26-gauge bonderized sheet metal. Use 2x4-inch drip edge flashing for fascia edge. Overlap all ends at least 4 inches. Use a minimum 4x4-inch L flashing at the junction of the wall to deck. Apply 2 beads of WP51 polyurethane sealant to all seams. Nail flashing in a staggered pattern every 4 to 6 inches. If the flashing is not bonderized, please contact your Westcoat representative. Place the WP25 metal lath on the plywood and cut it to fit the area, ensuring the edge of the lath is offset 2 inches from any parallel plywood seams. The lath should run across the grain of the plywood, across the long seams when possible. The grain of the lath should be placed so that it curves down at the edge of the deck. With the lath in place, start stapling in the center, working your way out. Staple the lath using 16 to 20 staples per square foot. Overlap the lath 1 to 2 inches and staple every 1 to 2 inches along the seam. With a hammer, lightly pound down any seams or staples that are higher than the lath. Metal lath should be held back 2 inches from all deck edges, leaving 2 inches of flashing exposed. The base coat consists of Westcoat's TC1 base coat cement and the WP81 cement modifier. Pour 1.25 gallons of WP81 cement modifier and up to 1 quart of water into a clean mixing bucket, and then add 1 bag of TC1 base coat cement. Mix until uniform with a mechanical mixer at a low RPM. Pour the mixture onto the metal lath and trowel at a rate of 40 square feet per batch. Trowel and brush the base coat up to the metal lath edge, leaving 2 inches of flashing exposed. Tap the deck lightly with a hammer to smooth out trowel ridges. As soon as the base coat is dry, typically 1 to 2 hours at 70 degrees, scrape high spots or ridges as needed before applying the Fiberlath membrane. Lay out the WP47H Fiberlath reinforcing mesh onto the deck. Lay the lath curl side down on the deck. The Fiberlath should be held back 1/2 inch from all deck edges, leaving 1/2 inch of flashing exposed. Overlap the seams approximately 2 inches. Combine 1 bag of TC1 base coat cement with 5 gallons of WP90 waterproofing resin. Mix until uniform with a mechanical mixer at a low RPM. Pour the mixture into the WP47H Fiberlath. Trowel thin and smooth at a coverage rate of approximately 250 square feet per batch, stopping at the Fiberlath edge. Leave 1/2 inch of flashing exposed. As soon as the resin membrane is dry, typically 1 to 4 hours at 70 degrees Fahrenheit, scrape high spots or ridges as needed before applying the slurry coat. Create the slurry coat by adding 1 gallon of WP81 and up to 1/2 gallon of water into a clean mixing bucket and add 1 bag of TC1 base coat cement. Mix until uniform with a mechanical mixer at a low RPM. Pour the mixture onto the surface and trowel smooth at a coverage rate of 100 to 150 square feet per batch. The slurry coat will be applied right up to all of the deck's edges. Use a paintbrush to spread the slurry coat onto the flashing, ensuring the mixture coats all corners. Surface should be dry between 30 minutes to 2 hours at 70 degrees. After the surface is dry, scrape or grind off any ridges or trowel marks. Pour 1 gallon of WP81 cement modifier in a clean mixing bucket and add 1 bag of TC3 medium texture cement. Mix thoroughly with a mechanical mixer at a low RPM. Using an acoustical hopper gun, spray the texture onto the deck with a circular motion. Spray continuously. Do not stop in the middle of the deck. Texture coat is applied at a rate of 150 to 200 square feet per batch. After a few moments, depending on the temperature, the texture must be knocked down. Use a rounded pool trowel for the best results. Allow the texture to dry up to 30 minutes to 1 hour at 70 degrees. After the texture has dried, lightly scrape any trowel marks prior to sealing. Mix all containers of SC10 acrylic top coat to ensure a consistent color for the entire project. If additional skid resistance is required, CA30 small safe grip can be added to produce a skid-resistant finish and reduce slip hazards. Roll 2 thin applications of SC10 using a 1/2 to 3/4 inch roller at a rate of 200 to 300 square feet per gallon. Roll the material in 2 directions to achieve a uniform finish. Coverage will vary according to texture. For small areas or in locations with cool temperatures, 1 coat of SC10 may be applied at 125 square feet per gallon. For best results, allow SC10 4 to 6 hours drying time at 70 degrees before allowing light pedestrian traffic or applying additional coats. Allow 24 hours to cure before heavy traffic. Allow 48 hours before heavy objects are placed on the surface. For more information on the ALX Pro system, please call us at 1-800-250-4519 or email us at info@westcoat.com or feel free to visit our website at www.westcoat.com.